Forever, a frozen sing-along celebration. Join in a fun storytelling and sing-along, capturing the best of frozen moments. For the safety of others during our presentation, we ask you to refrain from smoking, eating, drinking, and flash photography. We encourage photos and recording, but please do not obstruct the view of those around you with your smart devices. And please, feel free to sing along at the top of your lungs. Thank you.
Well, and I will be celebrating the Arendelle Festival.
Woo!
Anna.
Oh,
right, Princess Anna.
Princess Anna, come on, everybody!
Thank you. Now it's my great honor to introduce to you the royal historian.
Actually, it's just Eric at your service.
Thank you, just Eric. And what better way to celebrate Arendelle than for the royal historian to share the story of our kingdom and our queen, who just happens to be my sister, Queen Elsa.
Where is Queen Elsa?
I've been waiting for this moment for so long.
I don't know. Have any of you seen my sister? She's about so tall, blonde, kind of keeps to herself. Oh, and she has these weird icy snow powers, like, I know. Hey, Elsa, do you want to build a snowman? Yeah, that never really works. Hello, what are you going to do? It's almost time for the Arendelle Festival, and Elsa's missing.
Princess!
And everyone's already here.
Princess!
It's almost as bad as that blizzard. Well, almost.
Hi.
Oh, listen. We've got this. You go find your sister, and we'll share the history of Arendelle.
We will make sure that all of these nice people sing our anthems.
Okay. Yeah, that sounds good. Well, I guess we have to find my sister, but I'll be back. Elsa! Elsa!
Woo!
Are you ready?
I was born ready.
Then let's do this. Citizens of the Kingdom of Hollywoodland, we proudly present to you the story of Anna and Elsa. We also invite you to join us in the singing of the anthems of Arendelle. Now, if you don't know the words, just follow along.
I have a feeling they already know the words.
Where should we start?
Let it go! Let it go!
No, no, no! No, no, no! Too soon! That is the big one, so save it.
Where do you want to start?
Where every good story starts.
The beginning.
The beginning.
Okay.
Sequina!
No, wasn't that.
Sure.
No, that's not meow.
When was it?
It was later. Tails. Why are you doing this to me?
It was a beautiful day in the Kingdom of Arendelle.
That's all you had to say. There were two sisters, and they loved each other so much.
Princess Anna and Princess Elsa.
Elsa was born with special powers.
Magical powers. She could create snow and ice, and Anna loved playing in her snow.
She creates a snow monster.
Oh, you're getting ahead of yourself again.
Wow. This is when Elsa hits Anna with her powers and freezes her head.
They rush her to the trolls.
They do.
If you don't know what a troll is,
you're lucky.
Those are the trolls.
Mischievous creatures.
Mischievous creatures.
Strange magic.
Strange magic.
I never liked them.
You never?
Wait, what?
One of them rolled over my toe and it went wee 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 all the way home.
Well, Grandpa be king of the trolls.
He fixed Anna's head, but removed all memories of magic.
Listen to me, Elsa. Your power will only grow. There is beauty in it, but also great danger. You must learn to control it. Fear will be your enemy. No.
So you see, they thought it the saddest thing happened.
No more snowman?
No more snowman.
Get ready to set.
Yeah. Elsa? Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door. It's like you've gone away. We used to be best buddies, and now we're not. I wish you would tell me why. Do you want to build a snowman?
It doesn't have to be a snowman.
No way, Anna.
Okay, bye. Do you want to build a snowman? Or ride our bike around the halls? I think some company's overdue. I've started talking to the pictures on the walls. Hang in there, Joan. It gets a little lonely. All these empty rooms, just watching the hours tick by. I'm scared. It's getting stronger.
Being upset only makes it worse. Calm down.
No, don't touch me. Please. I don't want to hurt you. See you in 2 weeks. Do you have to go?
You'll be fine, Elsa.
I'll explain it later.
Where's the boat going?
I said I'll explain it later. Aaron.
Yes?
Why don't you turn around?
Okay.
What?
They die! Dead parents? What is this, Bambi?
No!
The Lion King?
No.
Finding Nemo? Cinderella?
Because the parents weren't dead in Coco.
Everybody else was dead in Coco.
It was sad, but this propels Elsa toward her destiny and also forwards our story to the best day ever, Coronation Day. Several years had passed, and it was finally time for Elsa to take the crown.
Elsa steals the crown.
No, she doesn't. Put it back. Did you see all of Arendelle History 101?
I did.
You are so bad. Well, this is when Elsa becomes Queen of Arendelle.
Her snowy powers.
She was scared they would show and be cast out of the kingdom forever.
All the while, Princess Anna was dreaming of opening the castle gates for the first time in forever. It's Coronation Day!
It's Coronation Day! It's Coronation Day!
The window is open, so's that door.
I didn't know they did that anymore. Who knew we owned 8,000 salad plates? For years I've roamed these empty halls. Why have a ballroom with no balls? Finally, they're opening up the gates. They'll be actual real-life people. It'll be totally strange. But wow, am I so ready for this change? Cause for the first time in forever, there'll be music, there'll be light. For the first time in forever, I'll be dancing through the night.
Don't know if I'm elated or gassy, but I'm somewhere in that zone.
Cause for the first time in
Princess Anna does meet someone tall, dark, and dreamy.
And there he is, Prince Hans of the Southern Isles.
I don't like him.
What?
He looks like his horse.
Okay. You're just jealous because he's dreamy.
You've said that already.
Well, I'm gonna say it again because
the dude is dreamy, am I right?
I know, I am sweating.
If he's evil and you know it, clap your hands.
It's coronation day!
Yeah.
And all the citizens arrived!
Yes, they did! And Elsa was able to hide her powers and be sworn in as Queen of Arendelle!
Party!
Yeah!
Baby shark, I do that, oh, little baby shark, I do that, oh, little grandma shark, I do that, oh, little grandma shark.
And they had chocolate, the sister's favorite food.
It was awkward between Anna and
Elsa. It was awkward right now.
They haven't seen each other in years, but all of that was changing.
Olympus and Han came back and they danced the night away.
Hans.
Oh, come on.
Don't you love true love? She doesn't want your chocolate.
I'll take it.
Here you go, love. Listen, that wasn't love. They'd only just met.
Well, apparently you don't know much about love. As a wise woman once said, love is an open door.
I could never shut you up.
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
I love crazy.
All my life has been a series of doors in my face. And then suddenly I bump into you.
I was thinking the same thing, because I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue. Each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I've never met someone who thinks so much like me. Jinx, jinx again. Our mental synchronization can't have but one explanation.
You
and I
were
just meant to be. Say goodbye.
Say goodbye to the pain of the past.
We don't have to feel it anymore.
Love is an open. Can I say something crazy? Will you marry me?
Can I say something even crazier? Yes! See to love!
Can I say something crazy?
Yep.
Ah! It wasn't love.
That might be your kid.
It might be. I don't know. Somebody call my lawyer. As the Princess Anna said, and I quote, you can't marry a man you just met.
And as Princess Anna said, and I quote, you can if it's true love.
But everything changed and it had nothing to do with love.
Well, Anna did push Elsa too far, causing her to throw ice all across the ballroom.
They called her a witch.
Yes.
They called her a sorceress.
Yes.
And then Elsa impaled someone.
No, she didn't.
It was on the bonus features.
No, it wasn't.
What were you watching?
Now she did manage to scare a lot of people.
I'm nearly as scared as that child. Our queen had... Her dad just sipping a beer. He's totally fine with me. Our queen ran away and froze our kingdom in the process.
Yes, sending it into a dark, cold curse.
It was beyond cold. It was frozen! This song is for you, Dad!
Snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and at looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know.
We don't want her to miss the Arendelle Festival.
Not that I remember.
Yeah, I think we'd remember seeing the Queen of Arendelle.
Okay, well, do me a favor and just keep an eye out.
Anything for you, Mr. Reindeer King?
Bahoba hoba.
It's just Kristoff.
Hey, speaking of reindeer, where is Sven? We barely recognized you without him.
Well, Sven found himself some carrots, and he had just got... Yeah... you know, I couldn't help but overhearing your story.
I could not noticing as soon as you walked out.
That lady liked it.
Lady, you can't tell, but she likes it.
You know, I kind of helped out. A lot. I mean, Princess Anna never would have made it up the North Mountain without my help.
Okay, and not to mention, you liked her.
That had nothing to do with it. Uh-huh. It was a blizzard. Lots of ice and I sell ice. Do you guys see my problem?
Nope.
Look, I had to help Anna to save my business.
Kristoff, we know the truth.
Yeah.
Alright, I've got to get back to Anna.
I knew it.
To help find Elsa.
Okay. Bye.
He is dreamy too.
How can you never call me dreamy?
Because you're dressed like an elf.
I have low elf esteem.
Okay.
Back to the story. Princess Anna, with the help of Finn and Kristoff, started a long, cold journey toward the North Mountain. Now they navigated deep and dark woods where wolves attacked their sled.
Werewolves.
Not werewolves. Just wolves.
Just wolves.
They lose his freshly lacquered sled in the process. The sled explodes like sleds do, so they continued on foot.
Yes, and then they came across this beautiful glen, and it was so romantic.
The real hero enters a snowman named...
Yes! He loves warm hugs and summer!
Snowman that likes summer, how can you not love this guy?
Summer?
Oh, I don't know why, but I've always loved the idea of summer.
And sun, and all things hot.
Really? I'm guessing you don't have much experience with heat.
Nope. But sometimes I like to close my eyes and imagine what it'd be like when summer does come. Bees, the buzz, kids will pull dandelion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer. In my hand, my snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned in summer. I'll finally see a summer breeze blow away a winter storm, and find out what happens to solid water when it gets warm. And I can't wait to see what my buddies all think of me. Just imagine how much cooler I'll be in summer. The hot and the cold are both so intense, put them together, it just makes sense. Winter's a good time to stay in and cuddle, but put me in summer and I'll be a happy snowman. When I like to hold on to my dream, relaxing in the summer sun, just letting off steam. Oh, the sky will be blue, and you guys will be there too. When I finally do what frozen things do in summer,
I'm gonna tell him.
Don't you dare.
Summertime.
Yes, and speaking of time, we're running out of it. We've got to hurry up and finish this.
Well, then let's go.
Okay. Olaf, Anna, Finn, and Kristoff make their way up to Elsa's castle on the North Mountain.
She tells Anna to go away, freezing her heart.
Accidentally.
When she learns of Arendelle's fate.
She sends Marshmallow after them, and Kristoff and Anna almost die jumping off of a cliff, but there was snow there to break their fall.
We know that Olaf has no skull and no bones.
I don't have a skull. Or bones.
Anna's hair starts to turn white, so Kristoff takes her to see the love expert.
She's getting colder.
She is.
And Poppy says,
only an act of true love can thaw a frozen heart.
Wait, he's British?
He's a Rolling Stone.
So they race off to Arendelle to find Hans, so he can melt Anna's heart with true love's kiss. See true love.
The prince leads a group of men to capture Elsa.
Why, Hans? Why? Kristoff gets Anna to Hans. And he leans in to kiss her and save the day when...
He laughs in her face.
Laughs in her... What? Hans is the bad guy?
He leaves her in a cold room to freeze to death.
Hans is the bad guy?
Did you sleep forever? No history 101?
Pretty much all of college. Well, Elsa escapes her prison. She's running across the fjord with Hans in hot pursuit. And Olaf goes to Anna's rescue.
I didn't realize that Kristoff, not Hans, is her true love.
Now Anna's out on the frozen fjord, and she is running towards Kristoff. Well, she's shuffling.
Kristoff.
And she sees Hans about to kill her sister, who has a migraine. Does she think her sister what to do?
What to do?
Get her some aspirin.
friend.
Good idea.
Here, Elsa, take these to make you feel better. I'm so sorry.
I got it. Olaf kisses Anna.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. And then everyone lives happily ever after, because some people are worth melting for.
The end.
The crowd goes wild. Woo!
Thank you so much. We have to go now. Bye-bye. Oh, what is the horn?
Princess Anna!
Kristoff!
Hello again.
Hey, did you find your sister yet?
Oh, well, we're still kind of looking for her.
Something's happening.
It's getting cold in here. Hey, that can only mean one thing, right?
I hope so, then we can really celebrate the Arendelle Festival! The Arendelle have been sharing our story.
Oh, thank you. What a very good story you told, though the ending did feel strange.
Oh, well, Olaf did help out a lot.
It was you who saved your sister and yourself.
Well, an act of true love will thaw a frozen heart.
You're my sister, Elsa. I love you.
No! Queen Elsa, I just have to let you know. The citizens of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land did a great job singing our anthem.
It was as if they had heard these songs before.
Yeah! Oh, you make all of Arendelle very proud. Yeah.
Come to the palace whenever you want. The gates are always open. They will never close again.
Yeah. Big story time blowout.
Thank you, Eric, and you, Arian.